In this video, we are going to see the next application of microcounters and time-delayed microprocessor, generating waveforms. So what do you mean by generating waveforms? Because see this, see here, like this creation of forms. Here it means it is zero and rising will be equal to one. So low and high voltage. So low, high, like this. If we connect this this output to an oscilloscope, we will get like this, like a sine wave. So this is what our aim. This is what we are going to see. But before going through that application of this generation of pulse waveforms, we have to go through some just brush up our memory regarding the rotate instructions, because here we are going to use the rotate instructions, which comes under the logical operations of microprocessor. So this under rotate, we have four instructions: RLC, rotate accumulator left, then RAL, rotate accumulator left through carry, then RRC, rotate accumulator right, and then RAR, rotate accumulator right through carry. As it is through carry, these two are dealing with 9-bit transmission, 9-bit rotation, and these two involved in 8-bit rotation. We'll see what it is. So here each bit is shifted to next bit when you give RLC, that is rotate accumulator left. Now let us imagine, let us consider this is the accumulator value. This each bit is shifted to next bit in the left position, so towards left it will be shifted. And here what happened, if this is the D0 bit, D1, D2, D3, etc. This D7 bit is shifted to carry as well as it is shifted to the D0 bit. That is rotates left. So if it is rotate, if this D7 is will be sent to carry bit as well as it is sent to D0. So carry flag is modified according to bit D7. So let us assume we have the value AA, which is nothing but equivalent is 1010 1010. After you give one RLC, what will happen? Now that is what we are going to see. So bit in 0 position is shifted to D1. D1 is shifted to 0. That is, all the bits are shifted towards left one position. If you give issue one RLC, the bits are shifted towards left. And here D7 bit is sent to the carry bit as well as to 0. So after the shifting, here this 0 becomes here. That's what. See here, this 0 is shifted here. 1 0 1 0 1 0, and this last bit is shifted as the first bit. It is D0. So if you see the equivalent 0 1 0 1, that is 5 0 55 H. Now we'll see the next one. RAL, rotate accumulator left through carry. Here it is considered only 8 bit because the D7 goes here as well as here. So anyway, it is an 8 bit rotation only. Whereas if you see here, this bit, the last bit goes to carry like the previous one, as well as what happens, already whatever is in the carry bit, that will be moved to 0, D0. Whereas here it is not that, it will be overwritten by D7. This carry bit will not be transferred here, but whereas here the one goes there and the zero carry bit goes to the D0 bit. So now it takes like a 9-bit rotation. So what happens, this 0 is transferred, that is towards left, 1, then 0, 1, 1, D5 goes to D6, D6 goes to D7, D7 goes to here one is there, that goes to carry, and then carry before moving this 0 is there, so that goes here. So that is what the appearance. See here, after the execution of one RAL, now our output is like this. In accumulator, the data is like that. So this one goes here, this 0 comes here, and all are shifted towards left. So 54H. This is 5 and this is 4. Now when you do again on RAL, then again the same thing, this 0 goes there, this 1 comes there, all are shifted 1 left. So here the carry bit black is modified according to d7. So if you see the last one given, again doing one more left shift, what happens? Zero comes here, and then see that the carry bit goes as the d0 bit, and whatever is present in d7 goes to carry bit, and now you can see it is a9. Okay, the next is write rotation. One is again the same thing with the each bit is shifted towards right, and the last bit d0 bit is shifted to carry bit, and carry bit is not shifted to d7 in RRC. It just rotate the accumulator alone. One day the carry bit will be replaced with the d0 bit. So this is an 8 bit rotation. So if you see this here, let us consider 81H, that is 8. 1 0 0 0, then 0 0 0 1. Okay. Now, when you issue an RRC, that is write rotate the accumulator, what happens? This one goes here. So, after the execution, carry bit becomes 1, and this one goes here. So, what happens? This 0 goes there. This, see here, 0 0 0 0 0 0, and this one comes here, and the last one. For D7, the D0 bit is shifted towards right. The next one is rotate accumulator right along with carry. This is also a 9-bit shift, 9-bit rotation. So if you see that this last bit goes here and this carry bit only takes only shifted to the D7 bit. So after the one shift right of that is the execution of RAR, now you can see this 0 is coming here, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. This one comes here, and the last one, this is moved here, and so now we have carry, but the previous 0 is shifted here to 0. So now, after understanding this concept, now we are going to move to the explanation of the generation of waveforms, which I have said in the initial stage. So generating pulse waveform. So now we'll see the problem statement. Write a program to generate a continuous square wave. This is what? A continuous square wave with a period of 500 microseconds. That is for this 250, for this 250 μs. So together it is 500 μs. Assume the system clock period is 325. So that is also given. And then use bit D0, the last bit, to output the square wave. So how we can try this, how we can generate a waveform using the registers. Now this is a program. Here what we are doing is MVI, move immediate, the D register, the value AA. So when you give AA, which is nothing but 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0, so it is similar to going high, going low. Going high, low, going high. So it's similar to our generation of waveforms. 1, 0. So alternative bits 1 and 0. So we move this value to D. Then move the value D, which we have stored. What is it? AA. That is first move to accumulator. Because with accumulator only, we can use the rotate operation. So we are going to achieve that with the RLC. So rotate left. Okay. So rotate left. The bits of present in the accumulator. So this is an 8-bit rotation, not along with carry. So what we are doing is we move this this value is moved to D, and from D it is moved to accumulator. Then we give a rotate left. So when you give a rotate left, what happens after RLC? What happens here? This bit is moved here. One is moved here, and so on. The last bit, that is D7, is moved to D0. So now what happens? Now we have to extract. We cannot pass it to the output. If we pass it, all this output will be will not generate. It will not look like a square wave. So what we have to do? We have to remove all these bits. So for that, what we are doing is AND with 0, 1. So when you are doing AND with 0 1, so 0 0 0 0 0 1. So what is it? It is used to mask. The AND operation is used to mask the other bits except wherever it has 1. So if you see that, only the output will be wherever it has 1 in both the positions. Okay, the accumulator as well as this bit, we only that will have 1. In all the other case, even if there is 1, since here it has 0, it will be 0. True and false will have false only. So now we are able to extract only the 0, 1 from this. So what happens after doing, so first we do the rotate, and then while we rotate this, because 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0 is AA. So after you rotate, you do AND. So in the case, the last bit will be extracted. So move the value of accumulator to, after rotating, move the value of accumulator to D, and then the D value is preserved, so that the accumulator value, what is the accumulator value? This value, that is this, after rotation we have this value. This value is stored back in D, and then with the accumulator value we do the AND operation. So in accumulator we have only this. Okay, now we do the AND operations and we are able to extract the last bit. Now what happens, that we are outputting, okay, we are sending it to the line, this output port. So in the case now we displace 1, that is on. Then what happened, we introduce a count, because we want that to be appear, that value that is 1 or a 0, that should be appear on the screen for some few seconds. So how, for that only we use delay counts. So we move a count. So this is what we have to find out, that is giving a time delay of 500 meters, but 500 meters is combined for lowering and higher, for lower and higher rising edge. So for lowering edge it is 250 and for rising edge 250. So we have to introduce a count of, because now only one is generated, for the next zero it will be another 250. So we have to use a count which will generate a time delay of 250 meters. So now for time being we don't know, we are going to calculate. So we move, we just write as count. Then decrement D, we keep on decrementing till this count becomes zero. Then when it becomes jump on zero, till it becomes zero, we just, this loop will be executed. So now in the last statement, it is nothing but jump to rotate. So once that value is, it will be staying there for some 250. After the 250 mu s is over, jump rotate. Now it comes to the first statement, it is move the value of D to A. Already we have saved in this value, what is the value? Now this value we have saved, this is the value we have saved in D. Okay, so now what happens, that value is again moved to accumulator. Then again we make a right left, that is right rotate. So what happens, left rotate, rotate left. So this is the value which is the accumulator. Now after some time, now this will be left rotate. Now one is shifted here, this is shifted, and the zero present here comes as the first bit. So now like this, each rotation will bring a zero or a one as the last bit. Alternatively, it brings 0 1 0 1 0 1 as the last bit, which will be ANDed with AND with the 0 1, and if here it is, if it is one, that one will come. In the next rotation, the zero will be there. So 0 and 1, it is zero. So all thing will be zero. So that is what we are sending it to the output. That is 0 1 0 1 and so on. So we have achieved our waveform by moving that value to the output port. Now we are going to calculate. We have to find out the delay. How we can do? So before doing so, first we'll calculate the T stage. So let us consider from this, let us leave this. So move A comma D will have a 4 T states. RLC has a 4 T states. Move D comma A is also, it is this 4 T states. ANA 01, it is a 2 byte instruction and it needs 4 plus 3, it is 7 T states. And then output, it is 10 T states. And then this MBA B count, this is nothing but 70. Let us leave this, because for this it is 14 T states, except the last T states, which is 7. So 7 plus 4, it is 11. Till that, all the rotations, it has 14 T states with this loop, inside the loop. So then outside the loop, we have another jump instruction, jump rotate. So that has 10 T states. So put together, we have, if you calculate, other than this, we have 46 T states outside the loop. So now, when we calculate this, delay outside the loop is 46 T states into the the time given, the clock frequency given is 325 ns. So when you calculate that, we get 14.95 microseconds, mu s. Then the delay loop include two instructions, DCR and JNZ. It is nothing but these two. So that is 14 T states. 14 T states, except for the last cycle, which has 11 T states. That is why we have given is 10 bar 7, because each time it has to jump to that. Only in the last state, when it becomes zero, it will not jump. It will go to the next statement. So for that, it reads only 7 T states. That is why it is 11 for the last state. So 14 T states, and we are subtracting one count, because if it is 6 times executes, means 5 times only it has 14 T states. The remaining one, it has only 11 T states. That is why we have given here as count minus 1. This plus the last count. Then when you calculate this, you will come across this calculation. Then total time delay is this plus this T naught outside the loop plus loop delay. So when you do that, you will have this, and then you bring the count this side and then calculate, we will come across this value 52.4 in terms of decimal places, which you convert it into hex, we have 34. So what you have to do is, in the count, instead of count, you have, that is here, you have to place a value of 34 H in order to obtain a 250 microseconds.